The next day, Thomas decided he wouldn't make any unscheduled stops at all. But he didn't want to leave anyone stranded, so he did stop whenever he saw a passenger waiting. And so it went on, all day long.
Late again, Thomas. Taking Bertie's passengers shouldn't make that much difference. You're still stopping at the same stations.
Yes, sir, I am, but there are a lot more of them, so it takes longer when they get on and off.
Well, really?
Well, I'd better be off, sir.
Sir Topham Hatt was becoming suspicious. Thomas was on his way back to Knapford, but he was very late again.
You're going too fast, Thomas.
My chassis is shuddering.
Thomas, the tank engine.
Sir? What are you doing here?
I know all about your unscheduled stops, Thomas. I've been following you.
Oh, I'm really sorry, sir. I was trying to help Bertie's passengers, but it got a bit out of control.
A bit?
I'll say.
Then you'll be pleased to know I've made other arrangements to help Bertie's passengers.
Bertie? He's back!
No, Thomas. He isn't.
Bulgy? But I thought you'd been turned into a hen house.
Only for a while. Then I was a mobile vegetable stand. And now I'm back in service.
Because...
Yeah?
Because... Oh, sorry, I forgot.
Okay.
Oh, Philip was getting nowhere. He still didn't know why he was number 68, but he was sure that every number must mean something.
The train leaving from platform 3 is the 1223 for Harwich.
There were numbers everywhere. All Philip could think about was what his number meant. He was travelling along the main line.
Huh? Oh, no! Get off the line! Oh, shoo! Shoo!
Oh! Oh, no! My sheep! My sheep!
You can't stay there! Gordon will be along any minute with the express! Yes! They're finally moving! Oh, no! He's almost here! to stop Gordon!
Little engine, whatever are you doing on my line?
Broken fence, sheep, all over the line. Phew.
James!
Oh, no!
Sorry, Henry.
There's clearly something wrong with your brakes, James. You barely managed to stop. I don't think you should be racing.
Maybe we should drive.
Good idea.
Oh, you're just worried I'll win and prove I'm the fastest red engine on Sodor.
I don't care about that. You need to go to the steamworks and find out why your brakes aren't working properly. I'll deliver your cars while you're having your brakes checked.
Fine.
But when James stopped at the next signal, his brakes didn't make the horrid noise they had before.
Huh? It didn't make a noise that time. It wasn't my brakes after all. It was the troublesome trucks pushing me like they always do.
James was so convinced that there was nothing wrong with his brakes, he didn't even bother having them checked.
Bye!
Kevin!
Yes, boss?
Are you leaking brake fluid?
Of course not, boss. I check regularly.
Then what is that?
What is what? It is me! No! It is me!
James did have a problem. He was leaking brake fluid. And without enough fluid, his brakes couldn't work well at all. But he hadn't heard that horrible noise since he gave Rosie his troublesome trucks. And soon, James forgot all about being careful.
Woo-hoo!
And then there was trouble.
No! I can't stop!
James!
Was a dark night, and the wind she did blow, and the ship was frail and tiny.
Salty?
Sorry, I forgot to tell you. Salty often sings sea shanties in his sleep. It took me a while to get used to it, but now I can't fall asleep without them.
Ships in the bottom of the deep blue sea, singing yo ho ho, what a
Oh, good morning, Edward. You look tired.
Oh,
it was such fun when you stayed the night at my shed. But I thought you would come back again last night. Didn't you like it there? How about the size? Was it big enough? Too big? Too small? Oh, it was too small, wasn't it? What about the...
I have to go now. Bye.
Have a good night's sleep, my friend.
The middle of the night.
Sorry, my friend. We have a second crew working all night to get James repaired as soon as possible.
Was exhausted. He hadn't had a good night's sleep for days, and now he was struggling to stay awake. Then there was trouble.
Hey, Edward!
Ooh. Edward! Watch out!
Huh? Something's wrong. Edward, are you okay? Oh no! He's asleep! Oh, no! Edward, please! You have to wake up! Edward! Edward!
Sorry, Percy. Thank you, Philip.
That's what friends are for. But it's a shame you don't like staying in my shed anymore.
We'll be right back.